Snoopy the Musical. We have had a great time performing this show. The kids have been working really hard for a really long time. They're doing an absolutely wonderful job. I know you're going to enjoy yourselves. This show is a little bit different. It doesn't really have a storyline. It's like you're reading one of those old Peanuts treasuries. You'll have a joke on one page, turn to the next page, new story, new joke, new story, new joke each page. That's what each one of the scenes and the songs is like. So it's kind of like a musical slash comedy review, but it's a lot of fun. The kids have done a great job bringing these characters to life. Characters that are very near and dear to me. My first big role on stage ever was the role of Snoopy, so it's very special to me. Anyway, a couple of quick housekeeping items before we start. If you have cell phones, please turn them off and don't have them out during the show, if you don't mind, so as not to disturb not only the people around you, but also the actors on stage. Also, there will be a 10-minute intermission. Wanted to let you know about that. And the other thing is, if you have small children, we love having the small children here to enjoy the show, but just be courteous if they do get a little bit disruptive, take them out before they settle down into the lobby and then bring them back in once they're settled, if you don't mind. All right, thank you so much for coming for our final performance of Snoopy the Musical. Now, enjoy Snoopy the Musical.
least one creature in the world who likes you.
But what if that creature walks off and leaves you?
You don't let him leave you, Charlie Brown. You tie him up or lock him in your eye. You just don't understand security, Charlie Brown. Snoopy!
Same old dog food.
I thought we were going to have grilled swordfish, but I guess we're not.
I love grilled swordfish.
Do you know how to grill a swordfish? You
called.
dog.
Hillcrest. thought you were my mom.
I was sure that you were my mom.
Oh, Mom. Oh, I know that you.
Every day would be Mother's Day if I could have you back.
Hey, you girls, we'll play some baseball.
Baseball?
Then all of a sudden, he'd tell me who he was. Then he'd meet another secret admirer. A penny for your thoughts, Lucille. I was just thinking, wouldn't it be wonderful if you could have your whole life to live over if you knew what you know now?
What do I know now?
Probably very little, Patricia. Which is not, however, the case with Ma. For instance, thank you. I know now that being born incredibly beautiful carries an awesome weight of responsibility.
True.
Isn't anybody curious to know what I know now?
Not curious.
Obligated, more like it.
Well, go ahead, Sally Brown. What do you know?
I know now that you can't bend a cracker, no matter how hard you try.
You may try.
I know now that your body isn't leaking when you cry.
Bringing with him toys for all the children of the world.
I've seen it about 10 times.
Shh. This is the first time I've seen it, Lucy.
Rosebud was his sled.
Never seen the sky as blue as it is today.
Oh, I have. I remember on June 14th, 2012, the sky was real blue.
Oh, yes. It was much bluer that day. And I also remember on September 2nd, 2013, the sky was very deep blue. And then I also remember on June 4th of the very next year.
I can't stand it! I just can't stand it!
They look like big balls of cotton.
Oh, yes.
I would just lie back all day and watch them.
You know, if you use your imagination, you can see all sorts of things in the clouds.
What do you see, Charlie Brown?
Well, I see a mermaid.
Thank you.
That's the way it goes.
When I had my choice of a cat or a dog, why did I opt for the latter? A dog! But he was different then. He was different when he was, well, small. He even used to come when I would call. Snoopy, Snoopy, here, Snoopy, Snoopy. Where did that little dog go? Only a moment ago, he was there, jumping in my arms, eating from my hands. I don't understand. Where did that little dog go? He's not the puppy I know. Something warm tugging at my sleeve, begging me to play. Was it yesterday?
Snoopy.
run-of-the-mill hound. A dog's life. What fool said that? Worth only 10 cents on the pooch market? Just another neighborhood mutt? Still, there was one place where I was valued, loved, appreciated, treated like I was a $400 fancy French poodle. Sometimes I miss that place. The old days of Hill Pup Farm. Maisie, will you still take me back? Got nothing to pack. Got no one to leave behind me. Who tries to find me? Daisy Hill had my field outside and live on my pride. I drive to this hard swallow. I'm just a hollow.
When you're distraught, there's nothing more relaxing than lying in your head.
There's probably a chick in clothes. Dear contributor, we are returning your manuscript. It does not suit our present needs. P.S. We note that you sent your story first class. Junk mail may be sent third class. Maybe they're trying to tell me something. Maybe they're trying to tell me that the short story form is unworthy of my talent. Maybe they're trying to tell me that I should attempt the novel. Why not? I got the time. I got the talent. I've got the typewriter. I've got the plot. I T it. Sometimes you writers take hours trying to find exactly the right word. It was a dark and stormy morning. Packed, flat, trite. It was a dark and stormy evening. It was a dark
softly. Whoa!
Could it be that
Hey, Snoopy!
to me, Chuck?
You can't explain love. I can recommend a book or a poem or a song, but I can't explain love.
Well, try. Try to explain love, Chuck.
Let's say I happen to see this really cute girl walking.
Why does she have to be cute? Can't you fall in love with a girl with freckles and a big nose? Explain that, Chuck.
Well, maybe you're right. Let's just say then I happen to see this girl walk by with a great big nose.
I didn't say a great big nose, Chuck.
You not only can't explain love, actually, you can't even talk about it.
Well, there was something else I was really curious about. Do you think you'll ever get married?
Oh, I suppose so. Just about everyone does.
What kind of girl do you think you'll marry?
I always kind of hate to talk about it. Because I'm afraid it might make me sound silly. But I would like the kind of girl that will call me poor sweet baby.
Poor sweet baby?
Uh-huh. Say I was feeling tired or sad or something. She'll cuddle up close to me, kiss me on the ear, and whisper, poor sweet baby.
Show me where it hurts, I'll tell you.
bowl of bananas.
Do you know what I'm doing, Linus? I'm pretending that you're taking me to the movies.
Well, I'm not. We just happen to be standing in the same line.
I'm pretending that you called me up and said, how would you like to go to the movies with me? And I said, that would be nice. Thank you very much for asking me. And then I'm pretending that you came to pick me up and we walked here together.
Well, you can stop pretending because it's never gonna happen. Wine, please.
All right, just for that, I'm going to take whoever's standing behind me in line.
Go right ahead.
One, please. Better to be the tree and the sea.
etiquette that's to think of someone who would like to be alone to prepare his acceptance speech.
I don't think that's an unreasonable request.
And considers that a reasonable request.
Weird. Just think. Head Beagle.
I wish I knew where Mom was. Beautiful moments are meant to be shared.
I'm gonna be the big bow wow. Wait till they see the
Some stars are big, and some stars are little.
You sure do know a lot about the stars, Lucy.
I did quite a bit of studying. One of my best subjects in school was agriculture.
I worried about this time of year. I quit last year. Around this time, it was 2 o'clock in the morning. I was asleep. Then suddenly, out of nowhere, this crazy guy with a sleigh lands right on my roof. He was okay, but those reindeer kept stepping on my stomach.
The biggest star measured so far has a diameter 2,000 times wider than that of the sun. I wonder how they measure it.
With a string.
Hi, Patty. The stars at Christmas time are beautiful, aren't they?
Uh-huh.
I think that there must be a tiny star out there. That is my star. And as I am alone, among millions of people on this earth, that star is out there, among millions of stars. Does that make sense, Patty? Do you think that means anything?
Sure does. It means you're cracking up, Chuck!
It must be nice to be believed in.
It is.
Wouldn't it be wonderful if everybody believed in everybody?
Beginning with me.
Beginning with you? Well, that'd be starting right down there, wouldn't it? I mean, you'd really be starting at the bottom. I mean, you wouldn't be able to start much lower than that. As a matter of fact, I don't think there's a word which adequately describes the depths you would have to descend. You'd have to make one up. Sub-bottom. I think that might do it. Sub-bottom.
Well, gotta start somewhere.
If just one person believes in you, deep enough and strong enough believes in you, hard enough and long enough before you knew it, someone else would think if he can do it.
I can do it.
Making it to to